Today's arrangement is color scheme Moribana with upright style in a flat flower container. Let me introduce today's flowers. Red coxcomb, white purple Japanese anemone, which is new to me, and white sprayed chrysanthemum. Hi, it's quick greeting from me for the first time in my YouTube videos. First, cut Japanese anemone as the subject. I place the flower on a flat flower container just to measure the length of the subject. The length of the subject is approximately diameter of the flower container plus its height. There are two kenzan lined up vertically in the container, and since it is upright style, the subject is arranged on the kenzan in back. I've cut off extra stem with no flower and moved on to next Japanese anemone at the secondary. In upright style, the secondary comes into the kenzan in front. Each style have certain definition in the length, degree, and where to place for the subject, the secondary, and the object. The length of the secondary should be 2/3 of that of the subject and should be arranged slightly left side in front of the subject. Speaking of degree, the secondary should lean left side at an angle of 30 degrees and at the same time lean forward at 45 degree angle. All other Japanese anemones are the fillers. They fill the space between outline flowers and make up the work. Regarding the secondary, it should lean a little more forward to be 45 degree angle, but I haven't noticed that. I was too busy with fillers and couldn't check its angle. Also, I was reminded to arrange short Japanese anemone in front of the secondary from my teacher, but I have completely forgotten about that. Sometimes I'm really into something, in this case Japanese anemone fillers, and overlook other crucial things. Distinct understanding on the process and flexibility is always important, not only in Japanese flower arrangement, but maybe in many other situations too. When I practice ikebana with my teacher, there is usually no sample work to refer. That means I need to remember the basic shape of the work and its procedure. We practice same style with various flowers repeatedly to acquire the basic methods. Let's see the progress so far. Now move on to coxcombs. I had two coxcombs. They are both fillers. Both of them seems almost same, but I compare how they look like and decide which one to use long and which one to shorten. The longest flower in ikebana work is usually the subject, so I have to cut the coxcombs shorter than the subject. Check all fillers not to be too close or too far from each other, and adjust a bit if some of them are overlapped. Prior to arrange the other coxcombs, I decided to arrange the object, chrysanthemum. As I mentioned before, in upright style, we arrange fillers in a triangle space created by the subject, the secondary, and the object. Thus, it's easier for me to arrange the object before arranging all other filler flowers. The length of the object should be a half of the length of the subject. I suppose you've realized how important the subject is. The length of all other flowers are measured in comparison with the subject. The subject is the standard. The object should lean right side at an angle of 45 degrees and 60 degree angle to lean forward. The defined angles are different depending on which style to use. I sometimes make a mistake in an angle, especially with the style which I'm not used to. I haven't practiced upright style for a while, so that it made me to arrange the secondary and the object with insufficient forward tilt. There are a lot to remember. All other remaining chrysanthemums are all fillers. I try to hide Kenzan as much as possible. The chrysanthemums had not yet bloomed and there were mainly buds, so I used leaves of chrysanthemum to organize. This is my work before my teacher's review. And now it's after my teacher's review. She tilted the object forward at 60 degrees, which made expand in whole work. You can compare the difference from former one. Let's see it up close. This is the view when I arrange flowers. Thank you very much for watching my video. See you, bye!